To be here in Amsterdam and attend what design can do, it's a pretty amazing thing. My name is Xiaodu Liu from Urbanis Architecture and Design. It's a we established the firm in 1999 in China. So it's been over 10 years. We have Shenzhen office first, and then also we opened Beijing office in 2003. So that's we have it's roughly about 80 to 90 people in total. As a group of architects, we saw that the architecture is not just one thing. It's not just the art. We believe that modernists believe like it has to deal with the real situation. It has to do something good to the society. The architecture can provide a better life for people. You know, urbanization is the most current thing happening in China, and it does greatly affect Chinese life, and we cannot ignore it. With the population like in China, it's very obvious. Okay, take an example as Shenzhen as a city. We have 15 million people living in the place. We also have the responsibility to let people in, live. So it's called a migrant workers. They are not just workers. Okay, they should have a chance to become citizens.
We really need to provide some solutions for low-income people, and we also look at the traditional Chinese vernacular. For example, this is called the Tulou in Southeast China. We actually made a model and combined with the urban village inside, like five people living in a 30 square meter unit. And they have very strong collective kind of public space. The ultimate idea is we can colonize the Tulou into the city.
Right now, a lot of migrant workers come to city to work, making money and build their big house in the countryside. This is a very environmentally unsustainable. It takes lots of energy and wasting. The land is contaminated, it's all be polluted. There are big pollution sources by those individuals. So I think people living in the city is the best way to preserve the environment.
We did this called the Mid-Hill Apartment and Hotel. You look at the space, the quality of the space. We have layers, there's a park entrance. The profile and echoes the mountain, the shape of mountain.
The solution is real. Okay, we were quite serious, we are very practical about this urbanization and the environmental issues. A lot of the things that just looks like very sustainable is actually not. My point is, if you really want to be environmentally friendly to the earth, you know, you build as less as possible.